I'd like Frank to join us. When we opened for Fabrangen, it was quite a happening there in DuPont Circle on Friday nights. How many of you remember those early Friday nights? A few folks here who are still around. Great. Incredible evenings. Great ruach, great dancing. And Frank joined us. Folks from other communities in the Washington area started coming down to Fabrangen to see what was going on down there. We had visitors from Tiferet Israel, and we had visitors from Har Shalom in Potomac, and visitors from Columbia Jewish Congregation. Who's here from Columbia Jewish Congregation? I see several hands. And from Har Shalom, Potomac, and the Sunshines are here, and others, the Fatherlings. And slowly we were invited to come and do some of our music in their shuls to open up the Friday evening services, although in the conservative shuls, we started before it got dark, you see, because the whole thing about using musical instrumentation in the early 70s in many conservative synagogues on Shabbat. And that started to change in many conservative synagogues little by little. So here's Frank. And here's one of our own melodies, Orza Ruah Latzadik Ul Yishrei Lev Simcha. Light is sown for the just and joy for the upright in heart. Orza Ruah Latzadik Ul Yishrei Lev Simcha. well, things kind of moved along, and we started doing gigs. Not just, you know, gigs. I never did a gig, you know, until I guess the early 70s. We were playing mostly for services at Fabrangen, and then invited to do some services for communities around the Washington area. And then some folks got it in their head, gee, this group might sound good at our bar mitzvah, you know, or our kids' bat mitzvah. So we started playing bar mitzvahs and bat mitzvahs and realizing, gee, this is also a way to make a living too, you know. So, and also found ourselves meeting a real thirst, a real need to have some Jewish music at Synthesis. You know, not the old rock and roll band or whatever. That wasn't the only way to go. And of course, you all know that very well because you are the people who invited us to your Synthesis. Then I took off for Israel. I kind of felt a little burned out, you know, here in America. The war was over, you know, and you kind of remember back then, you know, some of us were heavy duty into anti-war stuff. And decided I was never went to Israel. And I figured this is a good time to visit Israel, and I figured I'll go, it seems pretty safe over there. So I went in September of 1973. And I was in Israel for about 3 weeks, 4 weeks, and on a kibbutz in the Emek, Israel, and all of a sudden, the Yom Kippur War broke out. And so I was there in Israel for 7 months, and while I was gone, Sue Roemer, who I met at Har Shalom, teaching music, we both taught music in the school, she kind of took my place in the group and fulfilled some of the gigs that we had that year and continued our music. So Sue, come on up. Because the first time... actually that we played together as a foursome was not in the Washington area, but was in Iowa, in Des Moines, Iowa. When I came back to the States, it was just too much culture shock for me. I just couldn't be in such a such an environment. So I asked my friend, Max Tichton, who was also on the Mahalo board. I said, Max, he was also the director of national director of Hillel at the time. I said, Max, find me a Hillel position someplace, you know, in a needy part of the country. So he sent me to Des Moines, Iowa.
And it was cold.
It was very cold. And so I figured, okay, so I'll make a concert for the Fiddlers in Des Moines. I was missing my friends from back east, and I figured, well, this is one way to bring them out. And so this is the first time that the four of us performed together.
She
Missing my friends back here in the Washington area. And I heard that some of my friends started a restaurant called the Kosher Kitchen. How many of you have heard of it? All right. And came back, I had to be part of this, and so came back in June of 1975, and I walk in, maybe it was the second or third time I was there, and there was this young man sitting on a table, on one of the tables that we serve food on, sitting on the table with a sitar in his lap. And, you know, kind of just strumming on the sitar. It might have been one of the coffee houses or something that the Kosher Kitchen was known for in those days. There weren't a lot of other folks there that particular night. But that sitarist was Theo Stone. And now we don't do a lot of sitar in the group these days. But in 1975, we were into experimenting, and Theo and I were talking about, gee, wow, Hasidic raga, you know? Hasidic raga. It also turned out that Theo also played bass, and well. Ah, see, the sitar, yeah. And you should all know that, okay. Before he starts, we actually did this piece for the Rabbinical Assembly Convention at the Concord Hotel in 1978. Yeah. Of course, we've never been invited back. the words talk about building or completing the structure of the world, a Kabbalistic, a mystical concept that we participate in our actions in rebuilding, in making this world whole. And the melody was written by the Boston Ribs. Good to be here.
Theo, it's time to learn another piece on the sitar.
Yeah.
I remember when we were playing someplace in the Midwest and Theo put his sitar through baggage. In a plain pine box.
That was the concert in Atlanta, in Atlanta, Georgia.
And we were walking to the baggage claim, and people are standing there. Some very quietly. Others removed their hats.
Theo deserves a lot of credit. He hasn't played the sitar in 15 years, and he's been working this past month like a dog to get it together, to tune it, put all new strings on it, and really, for this evening, for one thing.
On American High, we recorded a song very dear to my heart. The words were written by Rabindranath Tagore and translated into Yiddish, and I set a melody to it. And I'll read the translation. Why did my little life die? I protected it from wind and from storm. I so wanted it to burn, and so my little life died. Why did my little flower fade? I protected it, cradled it to my heart. I so wanted it to bloom, and so my little flower faded. Why did my string burst? I stretched it tauter, higher. I so wanted it to play, and so my string burst. I'd like to dedicate this song to the spirit of little Becky.
Our boss is the sleet
It's also a sweet melody. Well, let's see, we're still in the 70s, but we're in the late 70s here. And I first met Larry Robinson at a folk festival. I forget which one it was. He was jamming with a bunch of people in the forest. I think it was at Wolf Trap. Is it possible? Was Wolf Trap in 1978, 79, something like that? And I was just amazed at how fast his fingers moved along that, you know, along the strings of that mandolin. And it turns out that Alan already had met him. And before long, Larry was doing some gigs with us, some symphonies with us. And so we welcome Larry Robinson, everyone. These words from the Abdullah ceremony, Hine El Yishuati, one of our own tunes. And, well, we'll just sing it. I'm not going to translate all the words.
And we're going to sing it fast, right?
Fast, oh.
We slow down.
Okay, let me start it off.
We forget.
Well, Alan on the album American Chai, he did both, mandolin and violin. Not the same kind, of course, but he did the... It's a great thing of recording. By the way, between 1975 and 1977, we came out with this album, American Chai. This is, you can't play it anymore. Who has a record player? You know? Oh, you still have it. But this kid comes up to me. It wasn't one of my own sons, but it was another someone else's kid. I forget who it was, just a few years ago. I was looking at the record. That's a large CD.
Did you translate this?
Oh, it's too long to translate. But the words talk about having faith. Words talk about how in song is our strength. The waters of fulfillment.
Push up the mind,
Thank you. A little more monitor on the mandolin, please. A little more on the mandolin.
We actually have a set sheet. We decided what we're going to do.
We actually rehearse.
Words by Pepernikov and one of my melodies. Maybe I'm building castles in the air, and maybe my God does not really exist. In my dreams, life is better, bluer, the heavens are bluer. I'm trying to do a little synopsis here. Maybe I won't attain my goal, maybe my ship won't reach the shore, but I just want to travel along a sunny path. Oh,
another one of our melodies from the songs, Roemer. Please sing with us. I'm sure many of you know the tune. I know the words. Not tears, it's sweat.
Sweat and tears.
That was the original name of the band, Blood, Sweat, and Schmaltz.
Barry?
She's been around almost as long as the Rolling Stones.
Larry, are you supposed to be playing banjo at this point? Are you following the set list? Larry has his own set list. Those of you who know Larry? That's it. Serve God with joy. That's what we're going to play. Yeah. back and forth using the names for God and the name Hashem, because I think we all consider ourselves, as David has said many times, reconformadox.
Except for Larry, huh? By the way, I was looking around the group here and see three of us were actually born in Brooklyn, if that means anything to anybody. But I didn't stay in Brooklyn too long. I grew up really on a chicken farm in New Jersey. And I think Sue's
family. I went to Jersey too.
North Jersey. And natives to the Washington area, I think. Frank, who are you? Frank is from Northern Virginia, and Theo and Alan are from Silver Spring. Delphi. Okay, we're going to introduce my family members later on, I think, beginning of the second set. We'll do it quickly. let's see. Late 70s, we started getting more into kind of the old-timey music. It wasn't called klezmer music at that point. We'd been playing throughout the 70s, and we played at Simchas, we played Russian Shares, and Hasidic tunes from Eastern Europe. And as we all know, in the late 70s, throughout the country, there began this revival of what has become known as klezmer music. Klezmer originally refers to the musicians. The folk musician is the klezmer, either as an individual or as a group. It could be a klezmer or a klezmerim. And then it became a style of music. So, Frank, would you... miss Frank. We really miss him a lot. The early 80s, Frank realized how precious his weekends were and really wanted some time for himself and for his family, and I guess the rest of us did too, but it was a little more difficult. we really...
And David, when you first started the clarinet, we really missed Frank.
Yeah. That's right. Was a Jewish band that I played with, so I was forced really to. I had a love for the instrument, mainly because of Frank, and so I really had to get to it. And so I've substituted all these years for you. I hope you come back.
We promise second half we're not going to talk so much.
Right.
Back to the Mamaloshin, to one of our favorite melodies. Words by Melchior Sternheim. We had a little Liedenbuch, a little melody that we sang in Mazel, in Brocha, in joy and happiness, the Baba and the Zeide, and the mother and the father, the Ganze Mishpacha. Okay?
A little more in the monitor, please, for Alan. A little more in the monitor, and hold on to your seats. Okay, ready for this little ride? And then we'll take a little break, about 10 minutes.
Y'all ready?
Where's Larry?
Train's gonna take off, man.
There is minus one string, but that's okay. No, it's a looking five string. Right?
Okay. The Fabrangen Fiddlers.
Thanks, Mom. Where's the drummer?
Not that old anymore.
Thank you.
Fabrangen Fiddlers.
Thank you. Theo Stone on bass. Theo for the bass. Now, Roemer. Last call, the two of them. Good. Sue, to Roemer. Thank you. I'm going to stop now. I'm going to stop now. 10 minutes. It is 10 minutes. Time to bring down.
So we'd like to ask Mindy to say a few words.
I feel like I'm at the reunion of the Beatles here. many of you know David so well that what I have to say won't surprise you. David's one of those people that can get you to do things that no one else can get you to do. And I can assure you that David is probably the only person in the Washington, D.C. area, probably in the world, who could get me to get up to do the fundraising speech. I met David the very first day I ever came to Washington, D.C., which was 17 years ago, and it should have been the omen. And I've discovered since then that David is someone who calls you every once in a while and will say, "Hello, I have a new idea. I have this idea I want to share with you." And you know already it means you're going to have to do some work or come to a meeting or something, but you never say no. And I have learned to say no to lots of other people and groups over the years, but I almost never say no to David's ideas. One of those ideas, most recently, has been Ma'alot. And many of you know what Ma'alot is, and I'm not going to spend more than a few sentences sharing this information with you. But I do want to say a few words about it, because this concert is the money that is being raised by this concert for those who Ma'alot. And I am on the board of Ma'alot, so I want to say a couple words about it. Ma'alot is a school for training individuals in Jewish music, liturgy, and the ceremonial arts. We have organized many programs over the last several years, workshops, lectures, concerts, and also a certification program for people who are serving as cantors or cantors. choral soloists in congregations throughout the Washington area. This was a brainstorm that once again came from David, and he got a lot of us enthused about this idea, and since then it is really mushroomed. However, as with every other organization and good idea, we do need more help, and that's one of the reasons this concert, the funds from this concert are being donated to Ma'alot. Have I done something wrong in front of the accusation? There is really nothing quite like it in the country. Ma'alot is really a very unique institution, and there's really nothing quite like it anywhere else in the country. In fact, people throughout the country often write to David and ask him about what we're doing and the ideas we have. As I said, it involves workshops, discussion groups, etc. You can read about all of this, so I don't have to talk too much longer, in this booklet, in the white booklet at the doors, and then there's a list of courses for Ma'alot, all courses in a separate blue booklet. One thing I want to especially call your attention to is the possibility of becoming a friend of Ma'alot. In addition to participating in this concert this evening and paying the fee at the door, you can also become a special friend of Ma'alot, and we have all kinds of categories here, which I'm sure you made up, right? Yeah. You can be a part of the Habirito beam, the good friends, the Habirim, you know, the great friends.
Next tune we call Hanarim, although members of Zimmer Chai call it the Rockadoo song. The Rockadoo. Members of Zimmer Chai, show yourselves. We're like, oh, a lot of you this evening. The Rockadoo song, because Eleanor Epstein took this little tune and created this incredible piece for her choral group. Songs, Harim, Rakadur, Ne'evim, and imagine the hills leaping like gazelles, like rams. It's one of those great songs, you know, and those of you who've traveled, certainly in Israel, even into the Smoky Mountains, every time you turn a curve, you know, it's like a whole new scene. It's like the hills are leaping with joy and for all of creation.
When did you see a gazelle in the Smoky Mountains?
In New Jersey, you saw it. It's New Jersey.
Oh,
its melody to Itzchaim Hi, Lamachasi Kibah, has been a very important melody in my life. So let's sing it, all of us. And play it. And play it in Kibji.
I was looking for my table because what inspired this tune was campaign for the Trees for Vietnam campaign, actually. Arthur Roscoe asked me if I'd write a tune for this little ceremony we planted a tree on the Capitol grounds, part of a tree campaign to help reforest those parts of Vietnam that had been destroyed. Interesting project. Mike, are you still here?
Yes, sir.
It's time
Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom. You can go back to the represented from every congregation in the Washington area. Well, except for, you know.
By way of introduction to the next two songs, when we discovered that this concert was the same weekend as the quilt weekend, we were a little concerned. We didn't want to conflict with anything that was going on. I hope many of you got down to see the quilt. I got a chance on Thursday to go to the first international meeting of the Jewish AIDS Network, a small but wonderful group of people from across the country and indeed around the world, from Israel, from Mexico City. People who built up programs, grassroots programs, recognizing that there is a need for a Jewish AIDS presence, whether we're helping non-Jews or Jews. Reaching out to the disaffected Jews in the community who might be HIV or AIDS sufferers, who may have never had a connection with the synagogue at all, who might be a cultural Jew. Programs we see that bring chicken soup to people's homes and touch them where it's needed. We found that there's a great need in many communities, and we think that probably there's a big need in the Washington community. There's a Baltimore group that is working, but there is really no Washington group that reaches out. We're not quite sure what we're going to do and how we're going to do it, but we need as much help as we can get. Barbara Sanka, who's sitting back there, and she's going to be up here at the end of the concert, will have a sign-up sheet if you have an interest to get together and sit and discuss and participate and form a grassroots organization and see what we can do as Jews to help this growing population of people with AIDS. And so we'll sing a song of social justice.
From the words of David, the psalm, Chesed and Mishpat, Ashira, of love and justice I will sing. LeDavid Mizmor, LeDavid Mizmor, Chesed Umishpat Ashira Lecha Adonai Azamera, Chesed Umishpat Ashira Lecha Adonai Azamera. Chesed Umishpat Ashira Lecha Adonai Azamera, Chesed Umishpat Ashira Lecha Adonai Azamera.
Social justice. I was raised on a lot of them. This one by David Edelstadt, a labor poet, which will sing a few verses in Hebrew, and Yiddish, and some in English and join us in the spirit. How long will you slave for others? How long will you support the oppressors who rob us of our bread? Here we go.
Shalom certainly know this, the Kehila Chadasha and several other communities. And Song of Bethlehem, me too. Woo! Please join along with us in this tune, one of ours, Michamov, Song of Liberation. First sung by our people as they cross the Sea of Reeds.
Oh,
We're coming to the end of this program. We'll be parting later on, those who are staying on. Before we continue with this next medley, I'd like to invite members of our family to just mention their names. Let's see if I can remember everybody. Peter and Debbie Roemer, where are you? Peter and Debbie, wave your hands in the back. Jesse's in his room, doing really good things over there. Let's see, Alan's family, I'm not sure who's here from his family, but...
Stand up.
Alan?
Okay, Diana, and my mom, and my parents, Seymour and Estelle. My brother, Paul, my boyfriend. And my Uncle Joe. And okay.
That's why we're always sold out.
Those are comps, though. Let's see, did you mention Melissa was not here, but Melissa, where's she studying?
Melissa graduated from SAIC in Chicago and is working for the Spurtis Museum. And she's painting.
Frank's family is here. Monica, please raise your hand. Monica, Christina, Daniel, and David. Great to see you. Larry's family, Larry, let's see, Lenore and Shira. That's your family, right? Daniel is studying in Michigan, right? Let's see, Theo's family, Howard, who's that? Howard. Is Jessica studying someplace? Is Jessica studying someplace? And
Chicky's here. Chicky.
Oh, Chicky and Lane, you got his mishpacha as well. And, let's see. My family, I don't want to embarrass anybody, but let's see. Aaron, you're in the back, so please sit down. Everybody, you should know that all of our kids are quite musical. In fact, let's see, my son Donnie is studying violin with Alan. He's got the best teacher in the world. And Frank's son, Daniel's studying clarinet. He has a very good teacher, too. And David just started what? Piano. David started piano. And Theo's son Howard is a beautiful, beautiful singer. And he goes with concert. By the way, we have Fabrangen
Fiddlers. And Debbie and Jesse are wonderful singers. I hope they're going to play downstairs.
Also, I want to mention Jeremiah playing baritone horn. And Samira playing violin. And Susanna playing cornet.
I'd like to mention Christina singing. Let's move on. What I'd like to do is dedicate this next medley to our teacher, our Rebbe, and Shlomo Carmel. This is called the Prop of Religion. Yeah.
been kept alive.
Yes.
And maintained, kept going, and brought to this time.
1971. This different way is playing.
Thank you.
several folks before we leave. David Eisner was for sound. And Wilson and Joe Wilson, all the folks who have gone through now to make this even possible, all the members of the Marlon Wood who are here, thank you so much. This is a great family. We really always talk to us, and it's really great to be here. So let's dance out.
And we're only half hour
late. There's plenty of food out there. So those who have your tickets to the party, find your way downstairs here in the...